Hari Om, let's start with the prayer. Om Samasta Jana Kalyane Niratam Karunamayam Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsa Chanuravardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Tvameva Mata Cha Pita Tvameva Tvameva Bandhusya Sakatvameva Tvameva Vijya Dravidam Tvameva Tvameva Sarvam Namadeva Deva Tvameva Sarvam Gurudeva Deva Hari Om. We are doing the Vedanta Sangraha of Sri Ramaraya Kavi, and we are at the sixth chapter where he is discussing the Lakshartha of Brahman. So scripture uses what you call Jahal Ajahal Lakshanam, indicatory meaning, so that one has to uplift the mind to see, because Brahman being all pervading, infinite, and navagachati namanaha and yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasaha. So no words can reach there, no mind can reach there, because there is something, nothing to reach, is because it's infinite, and infinite is beyond any sajati vijati swagata vedas. Therefore, from the paramarthika satyam, there is no jiva, there is no jagat, there is no Ishvara, it is ekameva advitiyam, one homogeneous pajnanam brahma, pure consciousness, undifferentiated consciousness, undifferentiated consciousness that would exist. Therefore, it's existent consciousness, and there is nothing other than Brahman. Brahman means infinite. There cannot be anything other than Brahman. Therefore, it is limitless, and limitless is anantam, anantameva, ananda swarupam. It's not happiness that one gains, it is the nature of happiness itself, because there is no inadequacy for to be unhappy being infinite. So that is a satyam jnanam anantam or satchidanandam or swarupa lakshanas, but they are indicatory definitions for a jiva who thinks that I am separate, Ishvara is separate, jiva is separate. So at the transactional level, scripture teaches that which cannot be taught, that which cannot be pointed out, and curious uses what is called lakshyartham. And in the lakshanas, there is a discussion in terms of three types of lakshanas. One is jahal lakshana, ajahal lakshana, and jahal adhal lakshana. And now discussing about jahal adhal lakshana, that means partly you have to give up and partly you have to hold on and take a meaning that's not direct vachyartham, but that indicatory meaning, and that's what is being pointed out. In that lakshyartham is the tattvamasi, you are that. You are that is similar to this is that devadatta, soyam devadattaha. So that devadatta is different, appears to be different from this devadatta. Lot of contradictory attributes, because that devadatta was so cute, so different type, and this devadatta is completely looks different. Therefore, the attributively they are different. Sthalam, time, space is different, but still the equation is pointed out. Soyam devadattaha, this is that devadatta by a teacher, and it says that means the teacher knows that devadatta, and the student also should have some idea of what that devadatta also, and looking at this devadatta, he has to compare and gain the knowledge, hey, this is that devadatta, I can't believe it. So that he dropping out all the contradictory qualifications, that is jahat part, and keeping devadatta alone, that is ajahat part, and making a sense out of it, because that devadatta, the devadatta are equal, and so equation is valid only from the essence of devadatta point, not from the attributive point, not from the spatial time coordinates point. Same way, tattvam asi, tat and tvam asi, three words are there. Tat stands for Ishvara, who is Sarvajnaha, Sarvatmaha, Sarvavyapakaha, and Sarvasaktiman, and all that. And Jiva, Tvam is Jiva, which is Alpajnaha, Alpashaktiman, Alpadeshavad, all those, the Alpa aspect is small compared to so big. And the equation is, that is you. And when the equation is done, and that is essentially Asi. Actually, we said Chandogya, it starts with Eka Vijnana and Sarva Vijnanam Bhavati. That was the foundation on which the discussion is taking place. And Eka Vijnana is the nature of the Brahman, and that is knowing Brahman, you know everything. And in the Mundaka Upanishad, a student goes to a teacher and asks, Kasminnu Bhagavo Vijnate Sarvamidam Vijnatam Bhavati. Oh sir, please teach me that knowledge, knowing which I know everything. So in all other objective knowledges, if you know something, you don't know anything else other than that. Even in that, what you know is very smaller and smaller. As you become super and super specialist, you become a narrower knowledge. Knowledge-wise, you know everything about nothing. And that's what essentially objective knowledge. And here, the student is asked, knowing which I know everything, and that says, yes, that knowledge is there. If I know Brahman, the Adhishtanam, the support for everything, I know everything that is supported. Because Brahman itself appearing as many. If I know gold, in principle, all ornaments that are created in the past, in the present, in the future are as well known. I may not know the attributes of each ornament, but I know the essential knowledge, that because of which they are, without which they are not. Whole Brahman is defined as yato vacho nivartante. So the from which the whole universe came, by which it is sustained, into which it goes back, that is Brahman. And that's what is being discussed here. And therefore, what is equated, Tattvamasi, is Chaitanya, Suddha Chaitanya Meva. Because that, the Ishvara has to be conscious entity, Jiva is also conscious entity, so Chit Swarupam, and he says the Chit cannot be plural. That's why we are here. So, Ataha, Tatpadasya Suddha Chaitanya Lakshanaha, Lakshanaha, Tvampadasya Cha Tathaiva. So, what is pointed out in Tat and Tvam is pure consciousness alone. And Asi Padasya Cha Tathaiva. So, the equation, that what is equated is only pure consciousness, and the other things you have to leave it, that's called Bhagatyaga Lakshanam or Jahal Adhal Lakshanam. And that is the Lakshana Vakyam. So, Asipadasya Tataiva, Chaitanyasya Chaitanyasya Cha Abhedaha. So, consciousness, Jiva is conscious entity, and the Ishvara is a conscious entity, and in the consciousness aspect of it, there is no difference. He is also conscious of, and you are also conscious of. You may be conscious of many things, you are conscious of small things. But consciousness, there cannot be any difference. And that's what is Chaitanyasya Chaitanyasya Abhedaha Ityartasya Ayuktatvat. This is what essentially implies. And Nahi Chaitanya Dvayam Asti. There is no plurality or duality of his Chaitanyam is different from my Chaitanyam. So from the Advaita point, Chaitanyam is pure consciousness and there is no duality in that. Why? Scripture itself says, Prajnanam Brahma. Consciousness is infinite, which means there is no divisions of any kind in the infinity. Etasya cha Chaitanya Lakshaka Tadadi Padatrayavataha Vakyasya Chaitanya Lakshana. So therefore, in these two words that are used, Tattvamasi, what is being pointed out is pure consciousness alone. That's what the scripture, and you are pure conscious entity, and Ishvara is also pure conscious entity, and that's what is being indicated. And here, justification is, Padartha Anupapatte Padana, Iva Padana Miva, Vakyartham Anupapatte Vakyasyapi Lakshana Vrutti Upagamat. Just as when you use two words and they are contradictory and they are used together, then you have to make drop the meaning of it and take something else. A simple example is boiling point. Boiling point is, boiling is one word, point is something else, and when you say boiling point of water is 100 degrees, so it's completely different between the two words, but it is indicatory of the temperature at which it boils. That's what has to be taken, and that's why this is, when two words are used which do not match properly, here it says even when they are contradictory, then one has to make a common that is applicable to for both of them, and that has to be taken. In the same way, if the word sentence is not completely clear and not doesn't apply as in tattvamasi, then one has to uplift the mind to see what is the essence that is being equated. So that's what he says. Padartha anupapattehe padana meva vakyartha anupapatte vakyasyapi lakshanavrutti upagama. So anupapatte, when it is impossible to make direct meaning out of the sentence, that means vachyartham, see, that is impossible, direct meaning, then you have to take the implied meaning of what is the secondary meaning implied, since the scripture is saying that, in fact saying 9 times, that means one has to pay attention to what exactly is being indicated. Anupatte vakyasyapi rakshanaruti pagaman. So therefore, when it is impossible for vachyartham, direct meaning, word meaning or sentence meaning, then you have to take an implied meaning. Amumeva vakyasya lakshyartham akandartham ahu. So in this way only, the vakyasya lakshyartham, the meaning of the sentence or the scriptural statements of you are the teaching, is to equate that which is divisionless, and that is being pointed out. This is akandartha, akandartham, akandartham ahuhu. So you have to bring that which is not contradictory to each, and that which is unbroken between tat and tvam, which is common for both, that alone has to be taken, and that's what called lakshana vruttihi upagamat, and akandartham ahuhu. So this is called also akandakara vrutti. So this is a akandakara vrutti's term is used in the Advaita Vedanta. So what that means is, it is the teaching indicating that which is akhandam, and therefore one has to take the meaning that which applies to both equations of the two ends, that is tat and tvam, and it is lakshyartham jaha adha lakshana or bhagachyaga lakshana. So evam eva, evam aham brahmasmi, ayam atma brahma, prajnanam brahma, ityadi vakyanam api suddha chaitanye lakshana uhya. In the same way, one has to imagine that the aham brahmasmi, I am Brahman. So I am Brahman, how can you say? Because Brahman cannot say it, Brahman being infinite, and I am, the fellow who is saying, is an individual there. So what is that implied is, I am stand for the existent consciousness aspect of it, which is same as existent consciousness of the Brahman. So that equation is akhandam, and therefore this is akhandartham and akhandakara vritti, a teaching that is pointing towards that, that lakshyartham is what has to be. So aham brahmasmi, ayamatma brahma, prajnanam brahma, consciousness is Brahman, and these statements are made. Even advaitam, every word that is description of Brahman is not really describable, because Brahman cannot have any descriptions, because it's infinite. Infinite is only means it is the not finite. So therefore, all descriptions are indicatory of the akhandam. Therefore, akhandartham eva, using this, the lakshyartham. Lakshana uhya iti lakshanaya brahma pratipadana prakaram. This is what the the Jahar Ajahar Lakshana or Bhagachaga Lakshana and how Brahman is indicated. This is what essentially the chapter actually ends with that. But we will try to discuss here what exactly involved in this Akhandartham and how the other Acharyas also describe the same Tattvamasi, and the if interesting to see how Advaita differs from the Visishta Advaita and Dvaita. So this Akhandartham, which is indicatory meaning, Lakshartham or Jahal Ajahal Lakshana, are derived at what is called Samanadhikaranam. Samana means Tattvam Asi, you are that. So you and that are being equated. So from my point, I am that. So says, what is that and what is I am, and how do you explain this? And Advaita is using Bhagachaga Lakshanam, that's called the Jad Adha Lakshanam, where you have to leave out the attributes of I am and that, only equate the essence, which is Akhandam. And the other Acharyas, there are different what called Samanadhikaranam. I am and Tat and Tvam are equal, Samanadhikaranam, and what is equated is only the just as Soyam Devatattaha. So there are different types of Samanadhikaranam. First one is Ekatve Samanadhikaranam. When two words are used and if it means same thing, then it is either one is Ekatve Samanadhikaranam. That means it's pointing to the same but from different aspects of it. Like Vishnu Sahasranama, he says all thousand names all pointing to the same. So each one is indicatory of Lakshartha of Lord. So Vishwam, Vishnu, Vashakaraha. So each word is, there are thousand words and all are pointing to the same thing. So they are Samana Adhikaranam. So anyone is same and equal to that which is being pointed out. And that is a one kind of Samana Adhikaranam. The second kind of is Upasanayam Samanadhikaranam. So if I go to a temple and say, hey, this is Vishnu. So if I go to Vishnu temple and there is a Vigraham there, says this is Vishnu. Then say, how can this be Vishnu? Vishnu is who pervades everywhere and this is only a stone and a statue here, and how can that be Vishnu? It says, no, this is Upasanayam Samanadhikaranam. You take this as a Vishnu and then pray. This is a, you are praying that which cannot be conceptualized, but you are conceptualizing for the mind, for your prayers, knowing very well this is what that is. Same thing happens when I put a salute to a piece of cloth with a design and saying that this is a flag of the nation, and I'm not saluting a piece of cloth with some design that is the representative of the nation, but I am saluting the nation there. So that's called Samanadhikaranam. So flag is nation. That is essentially the Upasanayam Samanadhikaranam. That's a one way of equating that which cannot be equated. And the third way is Visheshana Visheshabhyam Samanadhikaranam. Visheshana Visheshabhyam, that means two words are used, and if they're used in the same ending in the Sanskrit, Vibhakti, and they can have same meaning, provided it can also be Visheshana Visheshabhyam. One is attribute, another is the locus for attribute. And Ramananda uses that to explain Tattvamasi. Here the example is blue lotus. Blue lotus, blue is only an attribute of lotus, and blue and lotus are used in the same noun form, and therefore they have Samana Adhikaranam, but yet one is an adjective that qualifies the lotus. And it is the lotus is the locus for blue lotus, and blueness is only a visheshanam, that means an attribute of the lotus. Same way, tattvamasi, that means the jiva cannot be equal to the Paramatma, just as blue is not same as lotus, but at the same time, Jiva is Visheshana of Paramatma. So it is called organic relationship. So Ishvara is a big body, and if you think of Virat Purusha, and each Jiva is like a cell or equipment in that. So the infinite Jivas are there forming the body. So when I say my body is my property of this. This is a mind, this is a different type of body compared to the young body there or a baby body there. So each one has certain attributes which are different. So in the same way, in the Virat Purusha, which is Brahman, in that everyone becomes a Visheshanam. So that's why it's called a Visishta Advaita. So qualified Brahman. Qualified is, he is infinite. You are a finite, but you are a part of it, and that's what it is essentially understood, and that's how the Ramanuja interprets same Samanadhikaranam, using Samanadhikaranam, the Tattvamasi statement. So we have also in the Gita, Brahmarpanam, Brahma Havihi, Brahmagnyau, Brahmanahutam. So Brahmarpanam that is chanted before taking meals, but what it implies is Brahma Arpanam. Arpanam is a ladle that is used for pouring ghee during the yajna time. By obviously Gruhastha does that. And it says this Arpanam is Brahman. How can the Arpanam, a Brahman is infinite, Arpanam is a little small one, how can it be? It says you have to use Samanadhikaranam. And the Ramana says Upasanayam Samanadhikaranam. You have same respect as though it is Brahman. So just as we respect the idol, same way this is also respected as a part of his vibhuti. That's how Upasanayam Samanadhikaranam. Whereas Advaita says what is equated is not the form, not the finiteness, but the existence aspect of it is equated. The ladle exists and Brahman exists. Existence is pointed out, and existence is Sadeva Saumya Idam Agram Asit. That's what is Brahmarpanam. Same way the Ramanuja interprets as this, as a the part of it is a Visheshana Vishesha Abhyam Samanadhikaranam. Whereas the Dvaita philosophy says it is not Tattvamasi, it is Atattvamasi. Atattvamasi means you are not that. So if the Sanskrit is, you can split it that way, but question is why he has to teach you are not that. So the objection is that to 9 times it has to repeat that we already know, because I don't think I am Brahman. That's how you are started. That's what is your Ajnanam, and it's confirming 9 times you are not this, you are not this. Why do you have to confirm that? Says that you have to ask the Dvaiti. So there is a completely different meaning, because from Dvaita point, the Brahman is not a Upadana Karanam. So therefore, they have a different approach to the doctrine towards the philosophy. But they call it the Advaitas, Mayavadins and all that. But the point here is that it is indicatory definitions that are used, and is akhandartha jnanam, and this is what essentially implied in the Tattvamasi statement. So it is meant for pointing in the direction that one has to see, that which cannot be seen, that which can, no words can reach there, na vakgacchati and na manaha, mind cannot there. Yet we are, the scriptures saying pages and pages of description of this, and the point that is being is the Tattvamasi statement in Chandogya, we said, comes at 9 times, and there it says Aitadatmya Midagum Sarvam Tat Satyam Sa Atma Tattvamasi Svetaketo. So he says this essence of the entire universe, that means the Adhishtanam of the entire universe, because universe come from Yatova Imani Bhutani Jayante Yena Jatani Jivanti Yat Prayam Chabisham Vishanti, from which the whole universe came, by which it sustained, into which it goes back, that is the Brahman, and that which is without its infinite, but all appearances, mayadhyakshena prakrutihi suyate sacharacharam. Krishna also says, under my guidance, the prakriti, which is same as maya, is projecting. And in the maya, if I know, understand it's a maya, then the problem is solved. But I am taking maya as a real. Maya means that which appears to be there, which is not really there, is maya. But if I take that as real, then I have a problem. The fellow who takes his real, this teaching is, look in the direction, see that Brahman which is really real, everything else only adhyasa, a superimposition on top of Brahman. And that is what the lakshyartha, the ajaha lakshana, bhagatyaga lakshana, and tattvamasi statement, aham brahmasmi, etc. I am Atma Brahma, Prajnanam Brahma. We are all describing that which cannot be describable and quantifying or qualifying that which cannot be qualified. And it's only to take as Lakshyartham, not Vakyartham. That means you have to take the indicatory meaning in order to make the equation valid. That means what is being pointed out is pure Suddha Chaitanya Meva. And Suddha Chaitanya means the existent aspect of it. And the whole world is doesn't look like Chaitanyam, but what is equated is the pure Sat aspect of it. So we say, how can that may not be? If it is Suddha Chaitanyam, the whole universe is inert. That's why I try to use the explanation of a light theory, where those people who are familiar have heard me before, they understand it. There's a light you cannot see, because light cannot be seen, but only reflected light can be seen. That we understood again. You're looking at my hand, because you need looking at the hand. It's not the hand, it's a reflected light from the hand is what is reaching your brain as the image. And you think you are seeing the hand, but you are only seeing reflected light only. You cannot see the original light, because if I remove the hand, the light that is there where the hand was, you cannot recognize or you cannot see, even though you know it light is there. So light cannot be seen, but only light can be, existence of the light can only be proved through the reflection. But the whole universe, if it is completely there, then how come I see it only through via reflections only? And that's what has to be understood. And here the idea is being pointed out as through the Lakshyartha, and the whole process is only at the point of Vyavaharika Satyam. From Paramarthika Satyam, no teaching is required, no teaching can be there, because there is no teacher taught. Duality cannot be there in the Brahman, which is Ekameva Advitiyam. So all that has to be understood as a part of the Lakshyartham. So Adhyasa is a superimposition. So you're talking about how light theory, so light theory, when I say this object is red, that object is blue, even though same white light is falling, but since white light has seven components, as called Vibgayar or Vibjayar, so starting from violet to red. And when I see an object is blue, what is happening is white light falling on that object. The property of the object is such that it absorbs everything except blue. The other object absorbs everything except red. So I see different colors only because of the reflecting medium is different. So even though the consciousness is all-pervading Brahman, and which exists, so when it falls on the inert materials, only the existent part is reflected as though, but not the conscious part or ananda part. In the case of subtle material, both the existent part and conscious part gets reflected, because that's a property of the subtle reflecting medium. And ananda is not reflected. Ananda is reflected only when the subtle body can reflect not only consciousness and existence, but also ananda, when it is calm and serene. And that's where ananda also gets reflected. That happens particularly when I have fulfilled an intense desire, my mind has become calm and quiet at that time, then I can see that I am happy. I attribute that happiness to this coffee or this or that I got it. So a desire prompted happiness is also coming from myself only. The myself means that Ananda Swarupam that I am, but yet I am attributing to the cause for the happiness. Therefore I am going after another cup of coffee or another this and this and that and that. That's how the vasanas develop. So essentially their light property is that depending upon the reflecting medium, only particular and attribute of the light is seen. Same way, all pervading, pure, existent consciousness, limitless, depending on the reflecting medium, only existent part or existent conscious part and existent consciousness and happiness part all get reflected, depending on the reflecting medium, not on the original consciousness. Original consciousness, is this Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam or Satchidanandam? Is its intrinsic nature or Swarupa Lakshanas or Lakshanas that are being pointed out? With that, we separate and complete this 6th chapter and we'll take up this 7th chapter in the next talk. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.